Designing complex parts and assemblies in Onshape can be done using a number of top-down design techniques. You can design parts together in a part studio, derive geometry, or using context. These techniques are robust and easy to use, but sometimes it's more convenient to capture your design intent and control your entire design from a set of top-level global variables. Onshape now supports global variables through the new Variable Studio. A Variable Studio behaves just like a variable table, but can be inserted automatically into all part studios and assemblies in the current workspace. Change a value here, and each element that references that variable will be automatically updated, giving you a convenient way to manage your design from one central location. A Variable Studio can be added to a document either through the plus icon in the bottom left corner or through the variable table, which is now also available in assemblies. You can also insert an existing Variable Studio from the current document or another document and reference the entire table or pick and choose which variables you want to use. In this example, the cooling ducts are fastened to the enclosure with nut plates, bolts, and rivets. The assembly is made from a number of parts and sub-assemblies that are split across multiple documents for convenience, and a Variable Studio is used to manage the entire project. If the Variable Studio is in the current workspace, you can edit the values from anywhere where the Variable Studio is referenced. Having access to variables in assemblies opens up more possibilities to drive patterns, mates, gear relations, exploded views, configuration values, to name a few. In fact, any feature with a numeric input. Just like a variable table, you can easily reference other variables and create expressions, but the main difference is being able to reference variables from other variable studios, from the current workspace, or even from another document. This enables you to reference standard or company variables without having to look them up and re-enter them, which is time-consuming and error-prone. Simply insert another Variable Studio into this one. Whenever this Variable Studio is referenced, any imported variables are also inherited. When a change is made, creating a version propagates these changes to all the linked documents in the project. A pending update is indicated by a blue circle. You can then either update to the latest or select another version, release, or branch. Finally, as mentioned before, you don't have to inherit the entire Variable Studio if you don't need to. Unchecking the automatic insert or deleting the Variable Studio will break any design relations. You can then selectively add any variables you need. Variable Studios are a great way to manage design intent across a single workspace, across branches, and across an entire project of linked documents, keeping your designs and your design team on track.
In this release of Onshape, we're introducing a new hole type for the ANSI and ISO hole standards. In the hole tool, you will find tapered pipe tap as a new hole type that can be used to create holes in parts. These holes can easily be referenced using the hole callout tool in drawings, as well as the hole table. With the new styling changes, it will also be easier to reference these hole callouts. Named positions are getting a huge upgrade in this release, with a new UI that allows you to override multiple mates and their position within an assembly. You can now easily control the naming conventions and the values of multiple mates inside of the assemblies. Furthermore, you can now reference name positions in drawings. This allows you to clearly demonstrate how an assembly actuates and correctly annotate multiple positions of that assembly, giving you clearer assembly drawings that are easier to understand.
Frequently, assemblies reference the workspace or version of several components prior to release. Now, when you open the released version of an assembly, all the released components show with a revision icon indicating that they are released in that version. Version references that have been released are also updated. This eliminates any confusion about the release status of any of the components when viewing a released assembly.
New in Onshape for iOS, the ability for filtering through your assemblies or part studios is now available. Simply toggle on the filters and add search criteria as needed.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.